गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स. सो टुडेज न्यू ड्रग इज जेलसीमियम. यू कैन सी द प्लांट एंड इट्स फ्लावर्स इन द इमेज. सो इट्स कॉमन नेम येलो जैस्मिन. फैमिली लोगानेशिया. ब्रूअर डॉक्टर डब्ल्यू ई पेन. एंड पार्ट यूज्ड फॉर द प्रिपरेशन ऑफ द ड्रग इज द टिंचर मेड फ्रॉम द बार्क एंड फ्रॉम द रूट. जेलसीमियम इज द किंग ऑफ पोलियो बाय वर्च्यू ऑफ इट्स बीइंग अ ग्रेट पैरालाइजर. एज यस्टरडे वी हैव सीन बैप्टिशिया इज द किंग ऑफ टाइफॉइड. सो लाइक दैट जेलसीमियम इज द किंग ऑफ पोलियो. वाई? बिकॉज इट इज अ ग्रेट पैरालाइजर. सो इट इज नोन एज किंग ऑफ पोलियो. इट इज अ राइट साइडेड रेमेडी. Compared to Baptisia, it is left-sided remedy. Physical makeup, it is an acute remedy, so that there is a no specific physical makeup, but usually suited to children's and young people. Also, anemic girls. Especially women of nervous and hysterical temperament. There is a complete relaxation and prostration of whole muscular system with entire motor paralysis. So in gelsemium, you can see each and every symptom is associated with paralysis. So there is a complete relaxation and prostration of whole muscular system, temperament, nervous and hysterical temperament. Relation with heat and cold, that is thermals, it is not specific. They have complaints from heat also and from cold also. Miasm, psora, as it is acute remedy, it covers psora miasm. Sphere of action, it mainly acts on brain, spinal cord, occiput, neck, motor nerves, eyelids, vision, mucous membrane and on blood. So it acts on brain, spinal cord, occiput, neck, motor nerves, eyelids, vision, mucous membranes and on blood. So main action is on CNS, central nervous system. Then pathogenesis, by acting on roots of motor cerebral nerve centers, also motor area and on spinal cord and on both voluntary and involuntary motor nerves, it produces general state of paresis, means paralysis. And paralysis is physical as well as mental paralysis. And this is followed by cutaneous anesthesia, means there is a loss of sensation. It may be pain, temperature or touch or any pressure. So main action is on central nervous system. By acting on central nervous system, it causes paralysis. द माइंड ऑफ द पेशेंट इज़ वेरी स्लगिश एंड स्टुपिफाइड सो दैट इट इज़ कॉल्ड एज मेंटल पैरालिसिस. द होल मस्कुलर सिस्टम इज रिलैक्स सो इट इज़ नोन एज ग्रेट पैरालाइजर. So clinically, it is indicated for brain affections, cerebrospinal meningitis, cold, constipation, convulsions, deafness, dengue fever, diarrhea, diphtheria, dysentery. Emotions of effects of epilepsy. So there are number of conditions in which gelsemium is useful, like eye affections, fever, gonorrhea, headache, heat effects like heat stroke, sunstroke, heat cramps, heart diseases, influenza, meningitis, paralysis, ptosis. Ptosis means drooping of the eyelids. Also used for purpureal convulsions. Purpureal convulsions means the purpureal period means 45 days after delivery. So in that period, if patient having convulsion, we can use gelsemium. So used for sunstroke, tremors and writer's cramp. So there are number of clinical diseases in which gelsemium is indicated. Then ailments from. So the main ailment of gelsemium or causative factor is fright. Fright, fear, sun, damp weather and also alcohol. So what are causative factor? Fright, fear, sun, damp weather, alcohol, also elements from any exciting news. It may be happy news or bad news. So elements from exciting news, also ailments due to sudden emotions, shock or bad news. So there are number of causative factors like fright, fear, sun, damp weather, alcohol, exciting news and any sudden emotion or bad news which causes shock. In mind, the main characteristic symptom of gelsemium is anticipatory anxiety. Means they are having stage fright, they are nervous and having dread of appearing in public like argentum nitricum. They are also nervous to appear in exam, though he studied well. So there is a main feature, that is anxiety, mainly anticipatory anxiety. There is an anticipation of any unusual ordeal or preparing for church, going to theater or to meet an engagement which brings on diarrhea. Means due to anxiety there is a diarrhea. It is called as nervous diarrhea. Also it is a good remedy for examination funk. Means if you have anxiety for exam, you can take gelsemium 5 to 10 minutes before exam. If यू आर हैविंग सिम्टम्स लाइक जेलसेमियम और एंग्जाइटी ऑफ एग्जाम लीडिंग टू डायरिया, देन यू कैन यूज जेलसेमियम और अर्जेंटम नाइटिलकम, डिपेंड्स ऑन सिम्टम्स एट दैट सिचुएशन. There is a fear of death, like arsenic. There is a general depression from heat of sun or summer. So even due to heat of sun, which causes physical complaints, as well as they feel depressed in sun or in summer season. Children with fear of falling, they grasp the crib or seize the nurse. The symptoms are also seen in borax and sanicular children. So there is a fear of falling. There is a desire to be quiet, to be let alone. They does not wish to speak or have any near, even if the person is silent. So the desire to be quiet, to be let alone, does not want to speak, even don't want anyone near them, even the near person is silent, so they wants to be alone. There is a fear that unless he continuously moved, heart will cease beating. Means they feel that if they didn't move, their heart will stop beating. So they continuously moves. In keynotes, there is a lack of muscular coordination. Muscles refuses to obey the will. So this is the important keynote. There is a lack of muscular coordination. Muscles refuses to obey the will. There is a weakness and trembling, mainly of tongue, hands, legs, and of the entire body. So there is a weakness and trembling of the tongue, hands, legs, and of the entire body. There are chills without thirst, especially along the spine. So there is a chill along the spine which runs up and down in the back in rapid wave-like successions from sacrum to occiput. So chills which runs along the spine, which are rapid and wave-like. Gelsemium symptoms such as cold, fever, headache develops several days after exposure. Means if you compare aconite or belladonna, there is a sudden reaction or sudden development of symptoms. But in gelsemium there is a gradual onset of symptoms that they develop several days after the exposure. Dullness, dizziness, drowsiness and trembling, these are the important keynotes of the GIL syndrome. Dullness, dizziness, drowsiness and trembling means 3D. Dullness, dizziness, drowsiness and trembling or tremor, these are important keynotes of GILsymium. For giving GILsymium, these symptoms should be present in the patient. These are present with every symptom. It may be GIT symptom, respiratory symptom or a fever. So without these symptoms, don't give GILsymium. GILsymium is the great paralyzer. It is also a great flu remedy. It has also proved to be prophylactic, means preventive against flu. So it is excellent remedy for influenza, before, during and after influenza. Means before we can give as a preventive, during for the treatment and after effects, like in some cases there are complications like paralysis. In that case we can use after influenza also. Thirst. GILsymium patients are thirstless. Headache is relieved by profuse urination. This is also important keynote. The headache is relieved by profuse urination. The motion aggravates most symptoms but relieves muscular pains and heart symptoms. So contradictory modality, motion aggravates most symptoms but relieves muscular pains and heart symptoms. All complaints are relieved by stimulants, mainly by alcohol. Alcohol causes complaints and also relieves the complaints. Then headache mainly preceded by blindness, like in Kallivaikrum. We have seen the headache is ameliorated by profuse urination. Headache beginning in the cervical spine and pains extend over the head. You can see in the image, the pain started at the cervical spine and it is extending to the head or over the head. It causes bursting sensation in forehead and eyeballs, like sanguinaria and cilicia. So headache causes bursting sensation in forehead and eyeballs. Occipital headache begins in the occiput, spreads over the whole head and lastly settles over the forehead and eyes. If you compare it with cilicia, the headache starts at the occiput, spreads over the head and settles over the right eye. And in sanguinaria, it settles on left eye. So you can differentiate. skull feels heavy. Also, headache with heaviness of eyelids and bruised sensation. Before the headache, there is a dim vision or blindness. Also, sometimes there is a diplopia, means double vision before the headache. There is a pain in temples which extends to the ears. So it is very important. It is asked for 5 marks. Headache of the gelsemium is asked for 5 marks. So headache preceded by blindness, which is ameliorated by profuse urination. Headache begins in the cervical spine and pain extends over the head. And it also causes bursting sensation in the forehead and eyeballs. Occipital headache begins in the occiput and spreads over the whole head and lastly settles over the forehead and eyes. Skull feels heavy. It is important, headache with heaviness of eyelids, bruised sensation, and before the headache there is a dim vision or blindness. There is a pain which starts in the temples and extends to the ears. Also, there is a sensation of band around the head, above the eyes. So with headache, there is a sensation of band around the head, above the eyes. The scalp is very much sore to touch. And this headache is aggravated from mental exertion, heat of sun, lying with head low position, and from smoking. So headache is aggravated by mental exertion, heat of sun, lying with head low position, and from smoking. And headache is better by profuse urination. Eye complaints. There is a great heaviness of the eyelids, cannot keep them open. Also used for ptosis, that is drooping of the eyelids. You can see in the image the ptosis, that is drooping of eyelid. It may be bilateral or unilateral. Eyelids are heavy and consequently there may be ptosis. Also used for orbital neuralgia with contraction and twitching of muscles. Also there is a diplopia or double vision. In mouth, there is a putrid taste in the mouth. Tongue is thick coated, yellowish, with trembling and sometimes paralyzed tongue. So how is tongue of gelsemium? You can remember doctrine of signature. The flowers of the gelsemium are yellow, so the tongue is yellowish coated. So tongue is thick, yellow coated, with trembling and paralysis. इट्स अ वेरी इम्पोर्टेंट फीवर. जेलसेमियम इज इंडिकेटेड इन एनी एंड ऑल टाइप्स ऑफ फीवर. इट मे बी कंटिन्यूस फीवर, इंटरमिटेंट फीवर, रेमिटेंट फीवर, टाइफॉइड फीवर. सो इट इज इंडिकेटेड फॉर ऑल टाइप्स ऑफ फीवर. सो बिफोर चिल स्टेज कम्स द पेशेंट इज थर्सलेस एंड नर्वस. एज वी हैव सीन चिल especially along the spine, chill running up and down to the back in a rapid wave like succession from sacrum to occiput. Pulse is very slow, soft and compressible. So mainly before chill stage there is a thirstlessness, nervousness, chill especially along the spine, chill running up and down in rapid wave like successions from sacrum to occiput. Pulse is slow, soft and compressible. During fever there is a dullness, dizziness and drowsiness. These are important three D's: dullness, dizziness and drowsiness, which is accompanied with languor, muscular weakness and desire for absolute rest. There is a great heaviness of head and limbs. Severe headache which is relieved by profuse urination. So during fever there is headache which is very severe, which is relieved by profuse urination. And this during heat stage, pulse is full and flowing. In remittent fever, the stuporous conditions may appear in the last stage. Symptoms which appears after remittent fever are: there may be paralysis of various groups of muscles after fever. So you may heard like the fever is very high and patient become paralyzed, or lahan mulan madhe mhantat ki dokyat taap gela, tacha ma coma madhe gela kya paralysis zala. So the after symptoms of fever, like paralysis after fever: the tongue is trembling, paralytic with complete absence of thirst. So in any stage gelsemium is thirstless. Till we have seen many thirsty remedies like aconite, arsenic, bryonia. These are thirsty remedies. So gelsemium is thirstless in any stage. Then paralysis, as it is a great paralyzer or a king of paralysis. So paralysis is the main and important characteristic symptom in the gelsemium. Here also onset of paralysis is gradual, not sudden like aconite or belladonna. The onset is gradual, slowly, not sudden. So gelsemium produces general state of paralysis और पैरालिसिस इट मे बी मेंटल और फिजिकल. द लिम्स आर सो हेवी एंड पेनफुल दैट पेशेंट कैन हार्डली मूव देम. During paralysis, the mind is absolutely sluggish. Whole body, particularly the muscular system, is relaxed. There is a complete relaxation and prostration of whole muscular system with entire motor paralysis. Motor paralysis is paralysis which leads to movements, motor movements. Motor nerves are mainly responsible for movements. So, it is motor paralysis. Tremor. Tremor is the keynote of this remedy. There is a lack of muscular coordination, which is very well marked. Muscles refuses to obey the will. There is a weakness, trembling of the tongue, hands, legs, and entire body is confused to obey the will of the muscular system. So, gelsemium is the infallible remedy in post-diphtheric paralysis cases. Nowadays, the diphtheria cases are very rare, very, very rare, but the diphtheria is very dangerous disease in which there is a paralysis after diphtheria. So, gelsemium is a very good remedy for post-diphtheric paralysis cases. There is a paralytic condition of tongue, esophagus, and muscles of deglutitions. Means the muscles which are responsible for swallowing. So, paralytic condition of tongue, esophagus, and muscles of deglutition. So that when swallowing something, it does not go down, but it goes up in the nose, through which it comes out. So, due to paralysis, when person swallowing something, it does not go down, but it goes up in the nose, and through which it comes out. So, gelsemium also good remedy for diarrhea, mainly nervous diarrhea. As already discussed, they are having anticipatory anxiety, or before doing any important thing, they feel their diarrhea sets in. So, gelsemium has got purely nervous diarrhea. Causation of diarrhea, mainly emotional excitement, any fright, fear, or any bad news. So, characters of stool during diarrhea. Mainly diarrhea is involuntary as it causes paralysis. They cannot control the stools. So, involuntary diarrhea. The diarrhea is painless and cream colored. The diarrhea is aggravated by damp weather, bad news, dentition, tobacco, बिफोर थंडरस्टॉर्म एंड ड्यू टू एक्साइटमेंट. कंकॉमिटेंट सिम्टम्स विथ डायरिया. इट इज नॉट विथ ओनली डायरिया बट दिस आर कंकॉमिटेंट सिम्टम्स प्रेजेंट विथ ईच एंड एवरी कंप्लेंट. दैट इज थर्सलेसनेस, डलनेस, डिजीनेस, ड्राउजीनेस एंड ट्रेम्बलिंग. फर्स्ट व्हाट इज कंकॉमिटेंट सिम्टम्स. These are the symptoms which are not having any physiological or pathological relation with chief complaint, but having only time relation. So it is not related with chief complaint physiologically or pathologically. It has only time relation. It comes with chief complaint. So here concomitant symptoms are thirstlessness, dullness, dizziness, drowsiness and trembling. Modalities: there is aggravation from damp weather, fog, before thunderstorm, emotion, excitement, bad news, tobacco smoking, then thinking of their complaints, and at 10 a.m. So aggravating modalities are damp weather, fog, before thunderstorm, emotion, excitement, bad news, tobacco smoking, then thinking of their ailments or their complaints, and at 10 a.m. And they are better by bending forward, profuse urination, better in open air, better by continued motion and by stimulants. So ameliorating modalities are bending forward, by profuse urination, open air, continued motion and by stimulants. Relationship: it is compared with ignatia. Why ignatia? Because in complaints, the causative factor, in gelsemium, there is also causative factor, that is bad news or any sudden news, excitement. And in ignatia, there is also causative factor like complaints from bad news. But in gelsemium, there is complaints due to good news also. So exciting news which causes complaints, then we can think of gelsemium. Ignatia for complaints from bad news, like death of very dear and near ones. So in the acute state, we can give ignatia when there is a death of near and dear ones. But we can think of natremur in the chronic effects of death of near ones. So it is also compared with baptisia, as we yesterday only seen. For typhoid fever, we compare the gelsemium and baptisia. We also compare it with ipecac for GIT complaints and for fever. We compare it with aconite बेलाडोना, सिमिसिफ्यूगा एंड मैगफॉस। इट एंटीडोट्स चाइना, कॉफिया एंड डिजिटलिस। द अल्कोहलिक स्टिमुलेंट्स रिलीव ऑल कंप्लेंट्स वेल जेलसीमियम इज यूजफुल। सो विल रिवाइज अगेन। So today's remedy is gelsemium. We have seen common name is yellow jasmine. Family is Loganaceae. Brewer Dr. W. E. Payne. And its part used is tincture of bark and of the root. It is the king of polio by virtue of its being great paralyzer. Is the right sided remedy. As it is an acute remedy, there is no specific physical makeup of this remedy, but it is usually indicated in children and young people. Also, anemic girls, especially women of nervous and hysterical temperament. There is a complete relaxation and prostration of whole muscular system with entire motor paralysis. Temperament, there is a nervous and hysterical temperament. Thermally, it is not specific, they are aggravated by heat as well as cold. As it is acute remedy, the miasm is sore. Sphere of action, tax on brain, spinal cord, occiput, neck, motor nerves, eyelids. It acts on vision, mucous membranes, blood and right side of the body. Pathogenesis, it acts on central nervous system causing general state of paralysis. It is mental as well as physical paralysis. The paralysis is followed by cutaneous anesthesia. Cutaneous means skin, anesthesia loss of sensation. So loss of sensation over the skin, it may be pain, temperature, touch or pressure. The mental paralysis suggests mind is very sluggish and stupefied. The whole muscular system is relaxed. So gelsemium is known as great paralyzer. Clinically, it is indicated in number of diseases like brain affections, cerebrospinal meningitis, colds, constipation, convulsions, deafness, dengue fever, diarrhea, diphtheria, dysentery, emotion effects, epilepsy, eyes affections, fever, gonorrhea, headache, heart affections, influenza, meningitis, paralysis, ptosis. Ptosis means drooping of the eyelids, purpural convulsions, sunstroke, tremors and also for writer's cramp. Number of clinical diseases which are not given here, but if the state is like gelsemium, we can use them. Elements from means causative factors: fright, fear, sun, damp weather, alcohol. Elements from exciting news: it may be good or bad. Elements from sudden emotions or bad news, which leads to shock. In mental symptoms, the great remedy for anticipatory anxiety, there is a stage fright. They are very nervous and there is a dread of appearing in public, like argentum nitricum. They are nervous to appear in exam, though he studied well. The anticipation of any unusual ordeal, or the preparing for church, theater, or to meet an engagement, which brings on diarrhea. So it is the remedy for nervous diarrhea. It is a good remedy for examination funk, means the anxiety of exam. There is a fear of death, like arsenic. There is a depression from heat of summer, heat of sun. Children with fear of falling, they grasp the crib or seize the nurse, like in borax and sanicula. The desire to be quiet or to be let alone, that does not want to or wish to speak or have anyone near them, even if the person is silent. If we compared with Lycopodium, they also want to be alone, but there is a fear of alone, so they want someone in the near room, not in same room. There is a fear that unless on the move, heart will cease beating. Means if they have not continually moved, they feel that their heart will stop beating. Keynotes: there is a lack of muscular coordination. Muscles refuses to obey the will. There is a weakness and trembling of the tongue, hands, legs, and of the entire body. Chill without thirst, especially along the spine, which runs up and down to the back in rapid wave-like succession from sacrum to occiput. So in gelsemium, symptoms such as cold, fever, headache, they develop several days after exposure. There is a dullness, dizziness, drowsiness, and trembling or tremor. These are the keynote symptoms of Gelsemia. Dullness, dizziness, drowsiness, and trembling. Gelsemium is the great paralyzer. Also, it is the great flu remedy. So it has proved to be prophylactic against flu or preventive against flu. Also excellent remedy for influenza. It may be before, during, and after influenza. Thirstlessness is very well marked in the Gelsemium. The headache is relieved by profuse urination. Also, motion aggravates most symptoms but relieves muscular pains and heart symptoms. And there is a relief from stimulants. Headache is preceded by blindness, and which is ameliorated by profuse urination. Headache beginning in the cervical spine. Pain extends over the head, and which causes bursting sensation in forehead and eyeballs. Occipital headache, which begins in the occiput, spreads over the whole head, and lastly settles over the forehead and eyes. Skull feels heavy. Headache with heaviness of eyelids and also bruised sensation. Before headache, there is a dim vision or blindness. There is a pain in the temples extending to the ears. Also, there is a sensation of band around the head, above the eyes. Scalp is very much sore to touch. Headache is aggravated from mental exertion, heat of sun, lying with head low position, and from smoking. In eye complaints, there is a great heaviness of the eyelids, cannot keep them open. Eyelids are heavy, and consequently there may be ptosis. Ptosis means drooping of the eyelids. Orbital neuralgia with contraction and twitching of the eye muscles. There is double vision or diplopia. Mouth, there is a putrid taste in the mouth. The tongue is thick coated, yellowish, trembling, and paralyzed. Gelsemium is indicated for any and all types of fever. Before chill, there is a thirstlessness and nervousness. Chill, especially along the spine, which runs up and down in the back, and pulses slow, soft, and compressible. During heat stage or during fever, there is a dullness, dizziness, and drowsiness, which accompanied with muscular weakness and desire for absolute rest. There is a great heaviness of head and limbs, severe headache which is relieved by profuse urination, pulse is full and flowing, stuporous condition may appear in the last stage of remittent fever. There may be paralysis of various groups of muscles after fever. The tongue is trembling, paralytic, and with complete absence of thirst. Paralysis is the main and important characteristic symptom. The onset of paralysis is gradual onset. It produces general state of paralysis, mental as well as physical paralysis. The limbs are so heavy, patient cannot move them. Mind is absolutely sluggish. The whole body, particularly the muscular system, is relaxed. There is a complete relaxation and prostration of whole muscular system with entire motor paralysis. We have seen tremor is the keynote of this remedy. So there is a lack of muscular coordination. Muscles refuses to obey the will. Also, gelsemium is the infallible remedy for post diphtheric paralysis. There is a paralytic condition of tongue, esophagus, and muscles of deglutition. So that when swallowing something, it does not go down but goes up into the nose through which it comes out. Diarrhea. It is the main remedy for nervous diarrhea. Other remedy for nervous diarrhea, it is Argentum nitricum. Causation of diarrhea: emotional excitement, fright, fear, bad news, which causes diarrhea. Character of the stools. Stools are involuntary, painless, and of cream colored. Aggravation by damp weather, bad news, dentition, tobacco, before thunderstorm, and due to excitement. Concomitant symptoms: thirstlessness, dullness, dizziness, drowsiness, and trembling. Modalities: aggravation by damp weather, fog, before thunderstorm, emotion or excitement, bad news, tobacco smoking, or when thinking of their complaints, and at 10 a.m. And they are better by bending forward, by profuse urination, open air, continued motion, and by stimulants. Relationship: it is compared with Ignatia, Baptisia, Ipecac, Aconite, Belladonna, Semicifuga, and with Macfos. It antidotes China, Coffea, and Digitalis. Alcoholic stimulants relieve all complaints where gelsemium is useful. So thank you. Here we complete the remedy, gelsemium. If anyone having any doubt, you can call me or message me personally. Thank you.